Well, hello there, everyone, and welcome to Raising Indiana, a podcast devoted to the joys and pains of puppyhood. Here we'll cover everything from training to nutrition to care and psychology. This week, we're broadcasting from our tent in a very rainy, dreary Maine, but the fall foliage is at its peak, and it's nothing short of breathtaking. This episode is a special one, as we have with us two of my dear friends and longtime supporters, Jim and Rene Agreda, the fantastic husband and wife team behind Tripawds, a community devoted to two- and three-legged canines. Jim and Rene, hello, kiddos, and welcome to Raising Indiana.
Thanks. We're happy to be here.
It's our pleasure.
Now, the reason I've asked you guys to join our show today is to talk about three-legged puppies, and folks, there are lots of them out there looking for good homes. Now, I've known you since before our cross-country walk began and had the great fortune to meet Jerry, whom you lost to bone cancer. Catch us up from there on how and when Wyatt came into your world.
Well, it was about 9 months after Jerry passed, and I personally wasn't quite ready for a new dog, and we were definitely missing that aspect. And then one of the members of the Tripawds community that we operate came across a three-legged German Shepherd puppy about 8 months old who has been neglected and left tied up in a backyard, as too many of these dogs are, and they eventually realized his rope was all tangled around his leg. And these folks eventually took him to a vet who said the leg had to go, and these people said, well, we don't want a three-legged dog, put him down. So the vet tech there said, that's quite all right, we'll take care of it, go on your way. And they took care of an amputation, and they got in touch with the German Shepherd Rescue there, who fostered Wyatt, whose previous name was Chopper, not quite appropriate for a three-legged dog. They changed his name to Wyatt Ray Dog in memory of our dog, Jerry G. Dog, and contacted us knowing that we needed a new spokespup for Tripawds.com.
Good God Almighty. So the a-hole who had Wyatt was going to euthanize him just because they didn't want a three-legged puppy. Do you guys see that often?
Yeah, that is correct. And that, unfortunately, that happens a lot, either due to financial reasons, people can't afford to pay for the surgery, or they just can't stand the thought of their dog losing a leg.
So just to make sure I've got it straight in an old big dog's noodle, you didn't first decide to adopt a special needs dog, did you? But wait, actually, I mean, are Tripawds even considered special needs?
They're mostly not. I mean, they can do pretty much anything that a four-legger can do, but there are some things you need to keep in mind when you do have a three-legged dog.
So I wouldn't call it special needs. I would say there are special considerations simply because they no longer have their spare.
I'm sorry, Jim, the rain's coming down here at a pretty good clip, and I missed that last point.
Dogs are born with three legs and a spare, so once they lose that spare, you need to consider their activity and ensure that they don't injure a remaining leg because they no longer have a spare leg to lose.
Does anyone have any idea just how many three- and two-legged puppies are out there that need adopting? I mean, are there any reliable statistics?
No, and I wish they did, because even when you go to Pet Finder, you cannot search by three-legged dog, or you can only search by special needs. So I've tried finding numbers like that, and they're pretty impossible.
I actually considered adopting a special needs puppy after we lost Murphy, and Sheila, our producer, who helped us find our fourth fuzzy butt, Indiana, posted a few puppies on our blog who were missing a leg. And when we talked about having you guys on the show, Sheila found out that both of them had found good homes. Is that right, Sheila?
That is correct, and I hope that it is in response to finding Fuzzy Butt 4. I hope that we had a little hand in helping them find their forever families. But we had Alexander, who had an injury and had lost a leg, and we had a baby girl, Pyrenees, who was missing a foot. And I'm glad that those limitations, as some people might call them, did not deter adopters from giving these dogs loving homes. I don't have a Tripawd dog. I have a Tripawd kitty. And I actually found him in the middle of the road when he was 6 weeks old. And it was the next morning when I discovered that he had a paddle foot on his front leg, and he was born with a birth defect. And then I realized why he was in the middle of a highway at 11 o'clock at night. It was because he had a birth defect, and no one wanted to deal with that. Well, I tell everyone that Jack-Jack is now 4 years old, and he is the most well-adjusted animal of my six pets, and he is spunky. And if he had a fourth leg, it would simply get in the way and slow him down. So I'm glad that people realize that these animals aren't special needs. As you said, they need special considerations in their life moving forward, but it shouldn't be a deterrent for adoption.
That's fantastic news, Sheila. Congratulations. Indy says you're doing a great job with the blog, and he won't have to fire you this week. Now, I'm not a cat guy. I mean, I have a healthy respect and reverence for all of God's creatures, but don't do cats since you can't backpack with them. But that leads me to my next question. Is Tripawds strictly for dogs?
Actually, we just wrote about this, and Tripawds is about all amputee pets. We've written about donkeys. There's an elephant with plus pets we've written about, and we do have members who have cats. So it's not just dogs, and it's not just dogs with cancer. A lot of people have the misconception that Tripawds is all about cancer dogs. It just so happens that, unfortunately, the majority of dogs who lose a leg are to bone cancer.
Now, when someone makes a decision to adopt a Tripawd, is there any place out there on the Internet for those folks to go find one?
There is, actually. FE Tripawds discussion forums, we have a special section called our rescue forum. And we have people post dogs that they've seen in shelters. We go in there a lot and put animals' profiles up in there. That's the only specific place I know of. You can find them, like I said, in Pet Finder, but you have to dig through all of the special needs dogs there.
Right. We formed the Tripawds Rescue Forum for this exact reason. We didn't find any, you know, specific place for finding, you know, canine amputees who needed homes, and we know because of Wyatt that a lot of them are getting euthanized in shelters. So through the Tripawds Rescue Forum at tripawds.com/forums and the Tripawds Facebook page, when anyone posts one from a shelter there, we'll go ahead and add it to the Rescue Forum, and people can turn to that for special needs pets.
That's awesome that you guys have that tool for people looking to adopt a Tripawd. Now, prior to making such a decision, what considerations should people make first?
Well, the one benefit of dogs who become amputees early on in life is that they never really realize they're supposed to have four legs. So they adapt rather quickly to life on three legs and really don't know any other way, so they do very well when it happens to them young. But there are certain considerations since they no longer have their spare leg that, you know, you want to keep the hips healthy and you want to have, you know, regular checkups and make sure that you're giving an appropriate supplement if necessary. Rene?
You know, people should just keep in mind that they're not going to hike 5 miles with them. They would if you let them. But it's really not good for them. And so we like to say that Tripawds are great for people who are couch potatoes or just slightly active. But they're just not going to do those long trips. So, you know, there's lots of other fun things you can do together that help keep them strong.
Now, we're running out of time, but one of the things that we try to do on this show with new puppy parents is ask them to share with us one new lesson that you've learned this time around. What has Wyatt taught you?
I'd like to say that Wyatt has taught us a lot of lessons about humility. He's a very vocal, he's kind of obnoxious sometimes. and we're working on that. He was tied up when he was a puppy, so, you know, left in somebody's backyard and ignored. He has a lot of issues because of that, which we have learned to cope with and work with, and he's taught us so much about patience. And just not prejudging other dogs when we see them acting like he does.
Along those, what I've learned for anyone getting a puppy is to do your homework and know what you're getting into. Jerry was a shepherd mix and an angel dog, and we took someone's word that, you know, Wyatt's a wonderful dog, And because of his early upbringing, we understood or found out that he had some serious anxiety and aggression issues that we had to deal with.
Jim, Rene, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for the work you do to make the world a better place for puppies, especially those that are missing a limb or two. That's all the time we have this week. Thanks to our audience, supporters, volunteers, friends, and fellow animal lovers. From Hudson, Indy, and me, keep the faith and puppy up. And folks, support your local shelter or rescue and learn more about canine cancer at 2milliondogs.org.